And yeah, so it wasn't all play, it was work as well.
Were there any particularly enjoyable scenes to shoot?
Funny enough, the riots were probably some of the most enjoyable because, you know, you got, I think it was 2,500 mods they'd got, and they had a fantastic stunt arranger called Pete Braham, who's now sadly no longer with us, but would rehearse these fight scenes, would rehearse the large ones, and then rehearse the little vignettes and bits and pieces. But my overriding memory of the fight scenes are that you do it in 10 second, 20 second bursts, and then everybody, mods and rockers, would just laugh their heads off after the take. There's a scene where there's some stones being thrown. Now, those stones weren't stones, they were potatoes. But if you get hit in the head by a potato, it still hurts a bit. Do you know what I mean? But it was, I mean, just a blast. It was a blast.
What did you think of the finished film when you first saw it?
I didn't see it until the premiere, which was, again, was an extraordinary thing. My mum and dad came up from Portsmouth and got changed in the toilets in Leicester Square into their kind of evening dress, you know, because it was just, that's what they did. And again, too young to really understand about the impact of the film. But again, I mean, that was, I can talk about it, that was an extraordinary week because the film opened on a Thursday night, and the Saturday night we had backstage passes to go and watch The Who in Wembley, and The Who Roar Back, it was called. So that was just a week of kind of, that was a hard week.